Mr. Lewis, it is beyond an honor to be here with you. 53 years after you all marched on this bridge, why is it so important to come back and to keep coming back every year?
It is a must to come back. This is the place that gave us the Voting Rights Act, made it possible for hundreds and thousands and millions of people to be able to participate in the democratic process. People in Selma, all across Alabama, in Mississippi, and other states of the South struggled, fought, and died for the right to vote. In Selma, in 1965, only 2.1% of blacks of voting age were registered to vote. Mm. People were asked to count the number of bubbles in a bar of soap, the number of jelly beans in a jar. So we have to come back to remind people of the changes that we've made and changes we still must make.
And not to take it for granted?
It's taken for granted in so many parts of our country. It's not only affect African American, but white American, Native American, Hispanics, and others.
You marched across this bridge in a peaceful protest, and you were met with the billy club on your skull. Do you have memory of that moment that you got beaten almost to death?
I remember so well the moment that I was beaten and left the foot of the bridge. I thought I was going to die. I thought I saw death. I thought it was the last march. 53 years later, I don't know how I made it back across this bridge, but apparently a group of individuals literally took me across the bridge back to the church where we left from. But I do remember being back at the church, and someone asked me to say something to the audience. And I stood up and said something like, "I don't understand it. How President Johnson can send troops to Vietnam and cannot send troops to Selma, Alabama to protect people who only desires to register to vote." Mm-hmm. The next thing I knew, 16 other people, we were taken to a local hospital.
It must have taken a long time to recover.
Well, 2 weeks later, I was prepared to march again. The doctor.
2 weeks later?
2 weeks later, the doctors and the nurses took care of us. And I walked again across this bridge, all the way from Selma to Montgomery, about 50 miles.
Amazing. You have said, for people who don't think that things have changed, come walk in my shoes.
Yes, I believe that even now. When we first came to Selma, there was a sign saying white and colored. White men, colored men, white women, colored women. Those signs are gone. And the only places you'll see those signs today would be in a book, in a museum, on a video. In this city, when you enter the city sometime, you will see signs for the Klan rally. And you don't see any members of the Klan walking the street of Selma, walking through this county, harassing people.
Let's talk about right now. There is a movement of young people. You led a movement of young people back in the civil rights movement. There's a new organic movement of young people begging Washington, begging their local leaders for change. What do you see in the new movement?
Well, I see so much hope, so much of our future in this new movement. The movement of young people, the movement of women. And I truly believe that the young people and women will get us there. We're not quite there yet. But these young people and the women of America will be the leaders that would help build a new America, a better America.
As someone who successfully led a movement as a young person, what's your number one bit of advice for the young people, protesting and marching this month?
I said to young people, to the young leaders, just give it all you got and not get weary. Be hopeful, be optimistic, and take the long, hard look. We have some difficulty. They will have some difficulty. They will have some setbacks. But you cannot give up. You cannot give in. You will make it. They will lead us.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you.
Such an honor. Thank you.
Thank you.